And welcome to Lafayette Presbyterian. You are worshiping in person or on. Greetings to you. Today we will finish hanging, but all are welcome to come help. Chrismon's on the tree. Whatever. We'll do that immediately following those who are able. The group of churches who will meet at the marching over to the Highlands Church. For those who don't want to make people just prefer to sit in here and head over to the reception, we invite you to come if you are. Some prayer concerns this day. Pray for Ray as he has his procedure. I hope that goes well. Messages from two of my coworkers is probably in the final and is sleeping most of the time. Or my coworker, assistant principal, her mom has been in the hospital. Fortunately, I got a touch that she's actually going to be able to head home and continued healing our people. Thank you. Lee, at the age of 82, he lived with that family in your prayers. Well lived, and the promise. There are a lot of people on the mercies as people travel across all might. Go and come and those journeys. Let us know to worshiping God in spirit.
Join the Lord, all the earth. Come into God's presence with the one who made us, the sheep of one's holy pasture, and God's courts with praise. The Lord's name, for the Lord forever. God's faith to generation. Let us stand as you will. Gather together. Found in Ezekiel 11 through 12. Self will search for my sheep, as a shepherd seeks out the scattered sheep, my people. Seeking us, let us confession. What we have not answered out, what we have done together and cared for us, that same care and mercy. Forgive us, remind us, that we might turn toward for the whole world, step after tentative step. Forgiveness again in Ezekiel, Lord our God, I myself, I will seek the lost, strayed, and I will bind up the gates of Jesus Christ. And forgives us.
Peace of Christ be with you.
Let us pray. Thank you for this time. Thank you for this worship service given to us. And may amen. Join me in singing a 3-2. Remain seated. 25, verses 31, through the word of the Lord. Comes in his glory, and all the nations will be gathered before him, sheep from the goats, and the goats at the left, right hand. Come, Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for the world. For I was hungry and thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. And you gave me clothing. I was in prison, and you visited Gunter him. Lord, thirsty and gave you something to drink, stranger and welcomed you. And when was it that we saw you? And the king will answer to one of the least of these who are meant to me. Then he will say, you that are accursed, for I was hungry and you gave me nothing to drink with me. Naked and you did not get in and you did not visit me. That we saw you hungry or thirsty and in prison and did not take answer them. Truly I tell you, do it to one of the least of these, eternal punishment. But this is the word of the Lord.
Not yell at me too much when I say, because I forgot to put it in the bulletin, Sydney. Good and gracious God, we pray that the words of my mouth in your sight, you, O God, and our Redeemer, and that concerns me, scriptures, am with fresh ears. We have preconceived notions true when in fact they are not. For example, someone yell at me for argument that the God helps those. It does not be the most often quoted for Bible. If you want to find the Poor Richard's Almanac of that, go back even ancient Greeks. It is the opposite. God, Isaiah declares, for you has been a defense for the helpless, refuge from the storm. For while we were still help time, God, not even in the Bible, when we read things that are in the Bible, notions. I'll be honest, it's easy to do. It's especially easy for me, your pastor. You may be surprised to hear this, but in my 5+ years since taking this position, I have come to realize how little I actually know. In fact, one of the things I do know now is there's far more that I don't know than I do. That doesn't mean I haven't learned a lot, and I hope and pray I have passed some of those things on to you. But I have discovered that at least for me, regular faithful preaching gives me lots of humility. It happens every time I step behind this pulpit. Because sometimes, in fact, often I think I know something, or the interpretation of a text completely blown. Think we know the way therapy, we sometimes discover that fits. Familiar with it? His name is you might be familiar with all. If I were to ask you, what one would say, but that was not always. It wasn't one. Go back in green to go over gold, to go royalty. A little company. They're only that it featured Santa, their logo. Coca-Cola, I think we could call a success. Now, this is a parable. Characters in the drama before, goats. You got these. God is a vision for the final judgment. Purpose of telling us how we can world. In other words, believers and non-believers over, right? No. Because as I started this sermon, I made the mistake of doing some research and study. That stuff called learning, it can. You see, a reasoned research would say more faithful way, this passage is that those who have not fought will be judged in the people whom Jesus and the goats are those from the nation Christ's family, not Christians. This lens means the church and are not Jesus's. Them that they too will inherit him because they were them by being kind to members. My mind. Early church, because the members of God's filled the church were minority. They were put in the lion's den. The sheep in the story group when they were knows no homes, well, strangers are outcast. Them when they had no clothes, their faith. Now, way that this list is so, what Christ will judge both beliefs. Take Christ as you judge all folks. Now, if your news makes you a little nervous, judge. You know, condemn. That's not really the meaning here. It's about viewing things worth or value. Things we and others and a value. Seeing it this way because they disagree with us. Most folks, if we can find common ground to work for humanity, we don't church at Thanksgiving, a lot of things, because they're about the world. So what that's God's role. What we should do, those in need, Lord and Savior, is at an end. Too many people believe ends with what we say. Can be stated in a lot of ways. Well, I've been saved. Heart. Or for the best to believing in the tenets of Christology. Or some words that say, you're out. Because I know, I'll be honest, crap. Thinking intellectual matter. Believes and right doctrine. Journey is that following right doctrine, that's part of, if I understand, if you really want to show Jesus to have sound theological doctrine, especially with those who are, and the reality is, and if you act towards those in need, you can try. Means that Christ has come alive in compassion towards those. Anyone who responds to human responding to Christ, well, I'll be honest, this sanctuary gee, a bit nervous. We worry about oh, salvation by grace own by works. After all, the sheep are being saved. You see, the sheep did not know they were the genuine good that not to make themselves lineage. It came out of a heart of the divine, the creator. Sheep in this passage, in fact, had no idea they were even doing, done. These folks to be turned over for what we have here is not by works. No, this is a picture. Jesus didn't have PowerPoint at picture in words of our salvation by us to live like. Inside the family as the works, their response already dwells in every all created. Christian or not, when in humanity they respond away. They don't see themselves as they're just doing the good. This is truly respond in the world, whether we call it or not. It is if by knowingly claim that they and loving God. Also, as using form, age, don't we? Self-care. We Oh, I believe we are among the most overscheduled and stressed in history. Hey, oh, whether you're retired or not. When they were working, that retired dad has completely failed. We are pulled in some overwhelming, at best, to damaging self-behavior. And yet, therapists, they are patients that are finding a way helping others. Want to renew your soul or find a way to serve. Need in us to serve. In fact, few of us are excited about any reason. I really have this list that I want, but you will see this stoic, downright giddy gift to give them. You remember Scrooge, right? He's a ghost, but he did a story of himself, greeting people with laughter and being at the home where laughter abounded. Saved him on earth, even as though how he might be saved. Now I have to be on board in the fate of the goats, failed to feed Christ when he was hung, and so on. They turned away. And in turning away, they were turning away from God. Friends, we really need to see oration for them that cared. By the way, you and I. Friends, if you didn't hear this calling to follow Jesus or to identify yourself, know the calling to worship or theological belief. I spent some time with my brother. Thanks. It was a nice time. Now, many of you know my brother. He's ordained. He went to church outside of Nashville, Tennessee. He's a member of the Presbyterian, like us. If he has a room where in mothballs, I church in a tie, there must be his church. His church doesn't even. It's all up on. They don't have a simple get up during church to fix. I told him it's called that. And a lot more guitar, after all. Know that those that matter of style. Because folks, all be it in a robe or all we do and live out the call to Christ and acts of compassion towards those. The fate, hardness of heart in the human misery, that's what. And isn't it amazing God is what leads us to sin? And thus, this understanding, theology is not worship, nothing but a show. People, when we feel like it, not that. We need encouragement to know what and what the world, because it gets important. All that little observation, neither the sheep nor the goats, says the sheep and goats, when what? Thus, learning all we can is important. Almost amazing that we might, to Jesus Christ, the Emmanuel, the very presence of not even know it. That we can serve food and house and visit and care for doing it. What kind of God is it? And brush off without a second. What kind of God is it that we can ignore some homeless beggar? Doesn't sound like any God from God in my world history class. This is the kind of God who is born serving as a stable. It's the kind of God that crossed the border to a Savior who was blue-collared carpenter can be, his life working with wood, before serving as a teacher and a community organizer and a serious anti-religion, many feathers, executed on a cross, criminals. We best assume every Christ, and if not Christ-only, our quest to serve and do so faithfully, learned by regular work, theology, by pondering scripture, fellowship, and study, by being in sincere thing, for the voice of God just every once in a while, day after day. Urge and prayer to tell that we are to serve the least, the last, how we as individual faith are best served last and the lost. Of the church exists God, the only God there will be, and that we in Jesus, who is the Christ. Jesus in this passage before, that if we are to truly serve him, truly come to him, we do cease. That God has not taken up residence in this church or any other cathedral, because our God is too also clear that community is essential call for us in our lives. What are we going to learn about a God who would be among the most powerful? You to say that power is the most important. Except coming to church, but to see God, are there to tell the world about the splendor among the needy, among the lonely, and the powerful wouldn't give the time of day. This is the great privilege of to tell the world. And does this passage order to perform works of mercy? Of all those things we do, pearly gates, what we're called to do here, to do earlier in this, we're to love God. If we love God, because we're called to be, we will. You won't be able to do that. You can't help you. And the great secret is those acts of mercy. Best way I know to say, friends, we do so, the text of mercy, without even doing it on behalf of faith and our worship and our, when that great day comes, standing before, you'll be able to say, I saw you. Out clothes, and those who are lonely. And when I served them, realized by your grace, helping them, own heart, sir, to you. I thank you, Lord. I believe, know it. But I believe, well done, and faithful servant, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good and gracious God, we do believe. Help our unbelief. In good news proclaimed, as your creed found on the inside. Friends, what do you believe? Maker of heaven and earth, who was conceived by the heart of the Virgin Mary, dead and buried. He in from the dead. He sitteth on the right hand of God. From thence he shall come to judge the holy Catholic of saints, the forgiveness of life everlasting. Seated. Jesus, our neighbors in need, one with Christ. Let us all work in our community. Will you join me in the unison prayer of dedication? Name, because you have called us, sent us into the world to do now this offering. But through these gifts, the thirsty quenched. In Jesus' name we pray. 51, come ye thank the first and last stanzas. Be seated.
Let us pray. God, our judge and our redeemer, for the ways you have blessed our lives and gatherings with family and friends, off from school and work, for warm and warm hearts. Union, we lift up to you those who are suffering this morning, for people living in places of war, for people who are hungry, thirsty in immigration detention centers, sick, grieving, or lone provoker. Empower us, work, feed, clothe, and welcome people who lack life's basic necessities. Our voices in the public square for those violence and to pursue justice in our communities and the whole. Many more thanksgivings and petitions Jesus taught us to pray, saying, Hallowed be thy name is in heaven. Give us our debts as we fall not into temptation. But deliver glory forever. Amen.
Please stand for the benediction. The world in peace. Hold fast to what is good. Evil. Strengthen the faint heart. Honor all. The Lord your God rejoicing in the. May the Lord bless you and keep you and upon you and be grace you peace. Both this knowing that you, in the name of the Father and of the Go in peace.